line there. Still near here. This part is popping out. And I feel the other side, it is not popping out. It's more like it starts from the inner portion and works its way down here. It bulges out. So I'm feeling back here for what I have, and I want to make it symmetrical. So this feels like it has too much meat. So we're going to go ahead and remove some of that. Again, the shavings, we'll reuse them, and I'll probably use them to build up the knuckles. And again, this piece here, it seems like I'm using my finger to gauge it, so I'm feeling the bottom of the Lady Susan and feeling where the actual top portion of the paw starts or begins. And I'm coming over here, I'm getting the same feel, and I'm feeling that I'm too high up, so I need to cut into this here and somewhat, not so much of a 90 degree angle here, but you get that build. Let me zoom in so you guys can see a little better. There you go. Sharpen it in. Let's remove some of that. Now later I'll pick this piece again and put it in front of me and kind of use my left and right hand and kind of feel, and whatever does not feel correctly, I will go back and correct. But right now I'm going by sight and slightly feeling this to see what is correct. It's flat. I have it kind of flat across this here. See, I'm feeling the thickness of the leg. Feels about right. You can see from this portion to the knuckle how much space do I need. Right there to right there. So I'm right more or less where I need to be. And this create, make this like a 90 degree drop on where the knuckle is supposed to be. And let's go back and introduce our line that separates the toes. I'm going to round off the front portion of the toe here. This is the little ball, the tip, this area of the toe that holds the actual nail in place. It appears to be some kind of like a tip, but it's more like a little ball, if you will. Maybe I'm using the wrong term, but it's not really a ball. You get the idea. If you look at your dog, you'll see how that nail is held in place just by the last joint, the last portion of the under knuckle and the other nail. That's what we're trying to create here. This outer toe appears to be dropped, not the same level as the other two middle ones. So we kind of remove some here, but it still has that 90 degree here. Just squeeze in place. change positions because my hand is blocking your view. Right now this particular rear paw is facing forward, but on the other side is slightly outward, so I could either correct it right now or apply a little heat to it and just take the bottom portion of this paw and just kind of tweak it this way, rotate it slightly. Don't know what I'm doing yet, but I'll think about it. If I do that, I want to apply a little heat. Make sure it gets soft. Then move it and allow it to solidify again. So that way it'll adhere nicely to the rod I have in there. Feeling, trying to make the side symmetrical. This side I'm working on right now appears to be much bulkier than the other side, so I'm going to trim it down. I'm going to do that right now. To make it easier, I'm going to apply a little heat there. Now I'm using transparencies for this piece here because the actual fabrication of this here and getting everything right is crucial. Otherwise, the Ridgeback community will kind of front on the piece and say, well, it's nice, but you got that wrong, you got that wrong. And I wouldn't be able to say, no, according to your standard you have, it's correct. To get some advice from them too, because I noticed that the standard that was sent to me from Australia, I'm not sure if that standard is also used in other countries like the UK, because I noticed here in the States when you go to a dog show, they have a tendency to stack their dogs a little different than the way they stack their dogs over there. Here the hind legs are stacked somewhere outward and out. The standard was sent to me, it looks like they're stacked right underneath this portion, and it's not really with any width, it's actually the same width as the body, straight down, which I thought was not weird, but different from what they do here. I just need to find out what's acceptable, because I'd like to sell this dog here both abroad and also here to the breeders in the States, United States. Otherwise, I would have to make two different molds, one depicting the wider stance, and the other one that I have right now.